God bless each and every one of you. This program is going to be so powerful because we're going to go through the book of Revelation. I want to first of all have Pat say hello to you, our songbird.
Pat. Hello. We're very happy to be with you today. God bless you.
Yes. You know, the Spirit of God is so strong when we teach on the book of Revelation. And we see everything that's happening in the world, beloved ones. And as we see what's happening in the world, we know that the book of Revelation is coming to pass, that we're living in the book of Revelation. So I think it's very important that we understand and hunger for that book of Revelation, hunger for the words of God in the book of Revelation. Because he says everyone who reads this book and loves this book will receive a special blessing. And so today, I want to offer that special blessing to you as we go into the first book of Revelation. You know, brothers and sisters, we see what's happening in the world. And it's just heartbreaking to see the book of Revelation coming to pass. But God is judging his people, and that's what the book of Revelation is. It's a book of unveiling the truths of God, of the end times. And it also is blessing us and warning us to know the signs of the times. Jesus says you must know the signs of the times. And certainly, we are in that age. Pat, what do you think?
Well, I was just reflecting on a scripture a few minutes ago that the Lord says, not by might or power, but by my spirit, says the Lord.
And so you're saying?
So I'm saying that we have to trust in God to walk by the leading of his spirit.
Exactly.
And depend on him wholeheartedly.
Exactly. And you know, Pat, we're teaching at all of our lectures and all of our teachings at Christ in You, the Hope of Glory. Matter of fact, I just got back from Croatia, a tremendous trip of healings where there were up to 1,350 people at those services. But what the Lord is saying is walk in the supernatural realm. This is the time for my body, my bride, to walk as I walked in the supernatural realm of God. And that means to walk as Jesus walked. That means to walk in expectancy of God the Holy Spirit to move through you. And that's what it's all about. And that's why in the book of Revelation stresses the person of God the Holy Spirit. In the end times, we are to be moving in the supernatural realm because what's going to be happening upon the earth will not affect us if we're walking in the supernatural realm. So I'm going to read the first part of the book of Revelation. And chapter 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his services, things which must shortly take place. And he sent and signified it by his angel to his servant John. Verse 2, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ to all things that he saw. Blessed is he who reads those things and who hears the words of this prophecy. You see, here God is saying to John, write this down. Blessed is he who hears the words of God and adheres to this prophecy, who believes in this prophecy and keeps those things which are written in it, for the time is near. Now, this was written long ago. This was written when John was upon the earth. About 90 AD, it was written. And you know what we all know? Most of us know that it was written on the island of Patmos in Greece. And we've been to that cave where John wrote this book of Revelation. What did you feel about that, Pat, when we went there? Wasn't it tremendous?
It was such an experience to be there. We actually went twice. And there's a crack in the wall as you enter the cave where St. John the Divine lived.
Yeah, and I think, honey, that there's a crack in the ceiling also.
Yes.
From the voice of God, it was so strong. That's what they tell us as we go there. The monks tell us because it's operated by the Greek Orthodox Church.
Yes.
And they tell us that crack in the ceiling and in the wall is from the voice of God as he spoke to John. Oh, my goodness. And when you walk in there, you can feel the presence of God in that cave. And I pray that as we teach this lesson, you can feel that presence of God in your heart, in your spirit, that you'll take this in your spirit because the time, beloved brothers and sisters, is now. We're seeing what's happening all over the world. Every day when you read the newspapers or you hear things on the radio or TV, we know that God's second coming, Jesus' second coming, is drawing so near because all the prophecies are being fulfilled. It's a time of God's judgment upon the earth. All the hurricanes, all the floods, all the tsunamis, everything that's happening is told to us through the four horsemen of the apocalypse. But this week, we're going to study just chapter one. That's in chapter two and three. So it was written in 90 AD while Paul was in exile on the Isle of Patmos. And it was written to the seven churches of Asia. And these seven churches of Asia were very, very powerful churches. And they were the witness of Jesus Christ through the whole world, because it would go from Asia Minor onto the rest of the country, because it's a big seaport there in Asia Minor. And it would go from there. Smyrna, which is modern-day Izmir, is a great big ocean there, and it would go to all the parts of the world. And so John, who was the only apostle that was left living, all the others died. They tried to kill John, but you know what? He wouldn't die. They tried boiling him in oil. He wouldn't die. They tried everything to kill him, but he didn't die, because God wanted him to live for this prophecy, the book of Revelation. It says in Galatians 1:16, which was written by Paul, to reveal his son in me, that I might preach him among the heathen. Immediately I conferred, not with the flesh and blood, but with Jesus. In other words, Jesus comes to us so we can be his presence on earth. Christians, little Christ. That's why we're called Christians. And then in 1 Peter 1:7, that the trial of your faith, and believe me, as Pat said, the trial of your faith is now. We're all being tried because the enemy has been loosed and given permission to try us upon this earth. And we see what's happening in all the world, especially the Middle East. And I minister in the Middle East, and my heart is breaking for all the things that are happening. But I know it's God's will, because he's trying our faith. And as Pat says, this is the hour we must walk in faith. So 1 Peter says that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto the grace and honor and glory at the appearing of Christ. In other words, when Christ appears, he wants to know, do you have faith? Are you walking in faith? And as you start to walk, the mystery of God is this, as you start to walk in faith, then that grace is poured into you. Pat, it's really the days we're living in, isn't it?
It absolutely is. And it's that you have to take hour by hour, brothers and sisters. Sometimes yes. I have to pray every hour what I'm supposed to do next. And it really is totally trusting and just hanging on to the Lord to follow his guidance, so that you can, if he tells you to go the right, you go the right. Tells you to go the left, you go to the left.
Exactly.
So trusting in him.
Yeah, and that's why we need to be filled with the Holy Spirit, and we need to be walking in the supernatural realm, which is led by the power of God, the Holy Spirit. In the book of Revelation, the Holy Spirit is very, very important, telling you and I that we must walk in the Spirit, because the Spirit is what's leading us in these end times. In 1 Peter 1:7, we said that the trial of your faith is much more precious than gold. 1 Peter 1:13, wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind. In other words, strengthen your mind, brothers and sisters. Don't be in Never Never Land. Sometimes I think half of the body of Christ is in Never Never Land. You know, oh, these things are happening. Woe is me. But they're not girding up the loins of their mind. They're not walking in the power and faith of Jesus Christ. Wherefore, girding up the loins of your mind, be sober and hope to the end. You have to be aware, brothers and sisters. You can't be in Never Never Land. This is not the time to be lackadaisical or be in dreamland. This is the time of reality. And the reality is Jesus is coming very, very soon. And because of that, we're being tried very fiercely of our faith, so that our faith can be strong. The faith that's tried in the fire, it becomes stronger and stronger. The more that you're tried, the stronger your faith becomes. And he says, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end, for the grace that is to be bought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. And that's what the book of Revelation is. It's called the unveiling of things to happen. It's a book of prophecy. And Ephesians 1:17, it says, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation at the knowledge of him. So right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters, I issue to you the spirit of wisdom and revelation Just receive that wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of Jesus Christ, that you may know him greater than you've ever known him. And knowing him greater and greater brings revelation of him, revelation of his love for you, revelation of his power. And the book of Revelation really unveils the power and glory of Jesus Christ. And you know, Pat, you sing a beautiful song. What's the title of it?
You're My Glory.
You're My Glory. He is our glory. So listen to this song and just drink in the glory of God. God bless you.
You're my glory and the lifter of my head. You're my glory, Lord, and the lifter of my head. For that
our glory and he's the lifter of our head. He's everything to us. And he's coming very soon. And brothers and sisters, we need to learn how to walk in the supernatural realm by the power, being led by the power of the Holy Spirit, just exactly as Jesus walked. This is the day and the hour of the Holy Spirit of God. And it says it so clearly in the book of Revelation. And as I said before, most of the things covered in the book of Revelation are prophecy in visions and revelations to John. So there's lots of symbolism in the book of Revelation. And we're going to unveil that for you as we do this study, as we share the study of the book of Revelation to you. We see epistles are to the seven churches. Now, seven is the number of completion in God's operation. Seven is the number of God's completion. I'm going to read it one more time as we can go over the first two verses. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants, gave to John to show his servants, things which must shortly take place. And we can tell by the prophecy that tells us the four horsemen of the apocalypse, what's coming forth, that we're right in that hour now of the four horsemen of the apocalypse. And he sent and signified it by his angel to his servant John. In other words, the message was an angel to the servant John while he was in Patmos in that cave. And he stayed in that cave, and that was where he would pray while he was under arrest. Verse 2, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, to all things that he saw. Blessed is he who reads and those who hear the words of this prophecy and keep those things which are written in it, for the time is near. The seven churches of the book of Revelation were very important churches. And the seven churches of Revelation were recipients of the book of Revelation, of letters, which we're going to see in the preceding chapters. He rebukes, he condemns, he rebukes, and he also tells them their good points. But he warns his people of God's exhaustion of mankind, what's happening in the earth, not just the earth, brothers and sisters, but in our church, the churches that aren't holy churches, the churches that are preaching the word of God that tickles the ears of man, things people want to hear, get blessed, get rich, blessings are yours. We know that's all true. Blessings are ours. But the concentration should be on the hour we live in now and what Jesus expects from us to live the word of God, to live the word of God truly. Pat, we see this is not true in some of the churches.
That's true.
Brothers and sisters, I want to tell you something. Sometimes I'm just so ashamed of the way people dress to come to church. Yes. This may not seem like an important fact, but it is. Women should always be modest, whether they're in church or outside of church. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, and the spirit of lust should never come against the temple of the Holy Spirit. We should watch what we wear, and this grieves the Holy Spirit because you're a temple of the Holy Spirit if you're not dressed properly. And the same thing with the men. Dress properly as they come to church because it's honoring God, and this is what we should do when we come before the Lord, especially at the time of praise and worship to the Lord Jesus Christ. We should honor him in all holiness. And you aren't holy if you're suggestive in your wear and if you're inviting the spirit of lust to come against you. So we know that that's very important to the Lord. It should be very important to you. The seven churches of the book of Revelation are warning the people of God in exhortation to remain faithful in adversity. That's the main thing. As we go through the fire of what's going to be happening, we're to remain faithful in adversity. Just as Pat says, the devil comes to us from every way, and he's given permission by God. He can't do anything against you without permission of God. He cannot come against you without God giving permission. And why does God allow this? So that you and I can call out to him when we're in the fire and receive his faithfulness, receive his miracles. And what have you experienced as you call out to God hour by hour, Pat?
I call out for the grace because I can't do anything without God's grace in my life, I feel.
So that means that you depend on the Lord 24/7.
Yes,
you're depending on him all the time. Every move we make, we're depending on God. And that is so true. Now, the epistle to the seven churches, seven, we said, is the perfect number of God's operation. He talks about seven. We know there were 7 days of creation. We know that in the book of Revelation, there's seven seals, there's seven trumpets, and there's seven bowls. This tells us that seven is a completion of God's number. It's a number of completion for God. Asia was a province of the ancient Roman Empire, and in that province were seven cities mentioned. They were not, it was not only one city, but seven different cities. Now, we've been to Asia. We've been to Izmir, which is the book of Thyatira, but it'll come to me in a minute. But Izmir is Smyrna. That's it. Modern-day, it's old Smyrna, and it's modern-day Izmir. That's it. And I tell you, some of the spirits are still there that were there in the days that this book was written. In verse 3, Jesus says this. Excuse me, I got to get my glasses. Incidentally, I want to remind you, call in so we can pray for you. When we went to Croatia, brothers and sisters, it was so powerful. Pentecost Sunday, we had 1,350 people in Croatia, and every single person was prayed for. I'm still getting emails of miracles that happened at that time. So if you want a miracle in your life, if there's something special that you need, call into the station so that we can pray for you, because that anointing is still on us and strong. And you know what? God wants you to be under that anointing. He wants you to move forth in the power of the Spirit, to have faith, to pray for people to be healed, even your family, even yourself. This is what it's all about. I'm going to read verse 3 now in Revelation. So 2 says, who bore witness to Jesus Christ, to all things that he saw. Blessed is he who reads and those who hear the words of this prophecy and keep those things which are written, for the time is near. In verse 4, John, to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is, from him who is and who was and who is to come. In other words, grace and peace be from Jesus who was, always was and always will be, and is now present and is to come. He's going to come in his human body. We're going to see him in his resurrected body. Amen. And from the seven spirits who are before the throne of God, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler over the kings of the earth. He was a faithful witness, wasn't he? Jesus was faithful. As even as he cried in the Garden of Gethsemane, Father, let this cup pass from me, but nevertheless, thy will be done. And you and I say the same thing in the fiery trials that we're going through. Lord, we need your grace. Lord, remove this cup, but if it's your will, I will go through it. It's very important that we depend on God through everything that we go through. Depend on his grace, just as Pat says. His grace is sufficient for the weaker that you are, the stronger his grace is in your life. So if you're wondering why you're going through so many trials, it's the time and seasons. It's the time and seasons of the end times. There's more demons released. There's more things released in the earth, evil spirits released in this earth. And you and I have to learn to battle them, how to overcome them, and teach those around us how to walk in the Spirit. This is so important. And if you're not in the Spirit, you can't teach others to walk in the Spirit. Pat, how's your walk in the Spirit? What do you do to walk in the Spirit?
I know, like that, you were saying, Dr. Petronella, yes, you have to believe that God has a will for your life.
Amen.
And the things that are involved in it, that we're, it's not really of our choosing what the will of God is. And so basically, he has a purpose and a reason that's glorious. It might not feel at the time when you're going through the trial, but it does help us die to ourselves so that we can, that God can use us more.
That's right, because
more fully.
That's right. And so as we die to ourselves, that means we're dying to our flesh man. So our spirit man is rising. Our spirit man is becoming stronger and stronger. And as we're in that fire, beloved brothers and sisters, we're being tested. Do you know that gold has to be put in the fire in order for the impurities to fall out of it? My husband gave me a pair of earrings one time, and they were snap-on earrings, and I like pierced earrings. And I guess he didn't realize it. So I took it to the jewelers and asked him to put posts on those earrings so that I could wear them more comfortably. And he said to me, yes, ma'am, but I have to put that gold in the fire because every time it's changed, there's impurities in it that must come out. So every trial, and the Lord started talking to me about that through those simple pair of earrings. He started talking to me about how we have to, us vessels of gold must be put through the trial. Every time we're ready to go to a new glory, brothers and sisters, we're put to the trial. So the imperfections in our life, imperfections in our spirit can be gone in order to rise to that second glory or the next glory that God has for you. Because before he comes, his bride is going to be totally ready for him. Before he comes, we're going to be so in the spirit that when we see him in the clouds, we're ready to meet our bridegroom. We're ready to go up, and it's so exciting. I just praise God for that. In Revelation, as we just read in the verse 3, it says, blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy. So you're being blessed today. God's blessings are being poured upon you. And keep those things which are written. In other words, keep them in your heart. For the time is at hand. And the triune God is expressed in Christ. In other words, when we think of Jesus Christ, we know that there's Trinity there. There's God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So we serve a triune God. And the Holy Spirit, Jesus that lives within you, is the triune God. You are tabernacles of God. That means you're tabernacles of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And that's exciting. So we need to learn how to walk to express Christ in our life so that others will see Christ through us. And I know, Pat, you at work have had so many situations where they see Jesus in you. Can you share some of a couple of those?
Well, that actually reminds me that as a Christian,
yes.
You know, we're kind of on a stage all the time. So our best witness to God is that we have to remember that sometimes people are looking at us, and so we have to be an example of a good Christian because we're representing Christ.
Exactly.
And
many times, you know, our actions, Patricia, our actions will draw somebody to Christ more than our preaching.
Right.
How we handle a situation. I know in your life, they know what you're going through, with the situation with your mother who has Alzheimer's and you're her caretaker, and you also have a full-time job, and they see what you're going through and how you handle it. I remember you told me once when you were at a gas station, the gas station attendant said to you, you're so good to your mother. And that outward sign of love for her mother through trial and tribulation, the care for her mother, was the gospel spoken louder than any other words of preaching. Do you remember that, Pat?
Yes, I remember that.
Would you share with us that?
Yes, his name is Sergio, and... Mm-hmm. He actually works at the gas station, but I never even actually introduced him to my mother. I mean, I never introduced my mother to him. It's just, I suppose he observed me maybe speaking to her. She loves ice cream, so buying her ice cream, he was me buying her the ice cream. He observed me communicating with her. So since several of those times, he would always ask me without fail how she was doing when I would go get the gasoline.
Oh, how wonderful.
Yes.
Pat, so not only were you an example, but you stimulated him to pray for your mother or care for your mother also. I think that's so great. And we see here in Revelation, we read Revelation 1:3 and Revelation 4, John to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace be to you. So Jesus is talking to you through the book of Revelation, grace be to you and peace. Don't we need peace in these days? As you walk in faith, then peace enters. So right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I issue faith to everyone that is listening today. And he says also, grace be to you and peace from him which is and which was and which is to come, from the seven spirits which are before the throne of God. This is a beautiful vision or a beautiful vision that we see before us, that's portrayed before us. Before the throne of God, it's the Spirit of God, but it's shown in seven spirits. In other words, the seven spirits are one spirit. That's very important to know. So you see, brothers and sisters, this book of Revelation is totally about the Holy Spirit of God and walking in the power of the Holy Spirit of God. So as we look at the throne, we see the seven spirits of God before the throne. And each part of one of the spirits of God has a different ministry. And this is so very important. And it's seven, the completion, the seven spirits of God. So God the Holy Spirit is complete in his ministry, and he's complete in what he does for this, for us and the seven churches, which means our church. And this is very important to know. And then John 1:1 tells us, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. So we know that God always was and always will be and will always remain the same. And John 1:14, and the Word was made flesh. Jesus, the Word who always was made flesh and dwelt among us. That's awesome. That's why we have such a celebration at Christmas, to think that God dwelt amongst us. And we beheld his glory, and the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. So we know that Jesus was full of grace and truth and dwelt among us. And today he dwells among us, how? In the presence of the Holy Spirit of God. So as we give our lives to Jesus, and let's do that right now. If you've never given your life to Jesus Christ, why don't you get on your knees right now? And maybe you've given your life to Jesus Christ, but you know what? You've kind of backslidden. So repeat this prayer after me. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Today I give you my life.
Today I give you my life.
And I want you in my heart.
I want you in my heart.
And I want to live for you.
And I want to live for you.
I receive your precious blood.
I receive your precious blood.
That was shed for me.
That was shed for me.
For the remission of sins.
For the remission of sins.
And I believe you rose from the dead.
And I believe you rose from the dead.
And I want to live for you.
And I want to live for
you. Come into my heart, Jesus.
Come into my heart, Jesus.
Thank you for forgiving all my sins.
Thank you for forgiving all my sins.
And giving me your Holy Spirit.
And giving me your Holy Spirit.
Give me a love for your word.
Give me a love for your word.
That I may live with you.
That I may live with you.
With you in my heart.
With you in my heart.
And be your presence.
And be your presence.
Wherever I go.
Wherever I go.
Amen.
Amen.
So if you've said that prayer, maybe for the second or third time because you've backslidden, you're back again in the heart, in the hands of Jesus Christ. And if you said it for the first time, welcome to the family of God. You're part of us. You're my brother and my sister. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. You know, the time is passing so fast here. I'm going to just read a couple more scriptures about the end times, and then I want to pray for you for the healing of your body. So we go to Colossians 2:9, which says, for in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. In other words, in Jesus Christ is the whole triune God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And this is who's coming back to earth. Jesus Christ is coming back to earth, not as a child as he did the first time, born on Christmas Day, but he's coming back as the conquering Jesus, as he who has conquered life and death. And he's coming in the clouds, so we all will see him. And he wants his bride. You and I are his bride, and he wants us ready. Therefore, to know and experience God, we must experience Christ. In order to know God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, you must experience Christ. And if you've said that prayer, you've already taken the first step. If you're already a Christian, ask God the Holy Spirit to lead you deeper into the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And as he leads you deeper into the knowledge of Jesus Christ, he's leading you deeper into the mystery of God. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Each one has their own ministry. God the Father was in the Old Testament. Jesus, we know, is in the New Testament, died for our sins. And then he says, I must send you the Spirit. I must send you my Spirit. And that's God the Holy Spirit. He told the apostles, I will not be with you always, but I will send you. I won't leave you alone. I will send you my Spirit. So this is the day of God the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. And therefore, we know and experience God. We must experience Christ. We need to participate in the universal church through God the Holy Spirit. So everything you do to participate in the church today is through the unction and power of God the Holy Spirit. The seven spirits who are before God's throne are the operating spirit of God. So it's all one spirit, but seven parts that operate. That's so exciting. Him who is coming again. He implies Christ is coming again. Therefore, the seven spirits must be for God's move upon the earth. And that's exactly what it is. In essence, God's spirit is one. In the intensified function and work of God's operation on the earth, God's spirit is seven. In other words, there's seven parts of the Holy Spirit, but he's one spirit. As we operate in the gifts, as we operate in the fruits of the Spirit, which are so important, as we operate in knowing Jesus, for the love of God is shed abroad in our heart, how? By the Holy Spirit. That's another function of God, the Holy Spirit. So right now, brothers and sisters, we're going to just leave you there, and we're going to just pray for those who are sick today. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. If we could put the music on, please. Catherine Coleman, or the fire
of God. Listen, to let the fire fall.
Oh, to let the fire fall. Yes. Thank you. As we call out the power of the Holy Spirit upon your life, just let that fire fall upon you, brothers and sisters. Yes. Let that fire of God fall upon you. Yes. Just receive. Just receive the love of the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit in your life so you can go forth. Just receive the Holy Spirit. If you're feeling heat in any part of your body that is infirmed. In other words, if you have a sore shoulder or a sore foot, if you're feeling heat, that means the Holy Spirit is healing you right now. You know what? God is healing cancer right now. There's cancer being healed. Praise you, Jesus. Oh, there's cancer of the tongue. Somebody is watching or you're praying for cancer of the tongue. Call us in so we can pray for you. Let that fire come in you. Come, Holy Spirit. Call out to him. Let the fire fall upon your life. Let it fall. Come, Holy Spirit. Sugar diabetes is being healed right now. The blood of Christ is entering the blood of someone who has sugar diabetes, and you're being healed right now in Jesus' mighty name. There's a family that the Father has left, the family. The Lord wants you to know that his Spirit, God the Holy Spirit, is drawing that father back to the family. Thank you, Jesus, for healing the family. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. There's a young man who's infirmed in his legs. I don't know how you got infirmity in your legs, but you can't move your legs. I don't know if it was from an accident, but you're feeling heat in the lower part of your back, and you're feeling heat in your legs. In Jesus' mighty name, what do you feel, Pat?
I don't feel anything right now.
Yes, shut up. God is healing someone who's been expressly depressed. You've been so depressed, and the glory of God is filling your mind right now with his power. And you're being delivered. You're being delivered right now from depression. There's several people that are watching now that are being delivered from depression in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There's arthritis. Somebody who has hands that you haven't been able to operate, even pick things up, because you can't operate your fingers because of arthritis. And God is healing that arthritis right now. Just move those hands. Let the heat of God go into those fingers and knuckles and hands of yours in Jesus' mighty name. There's somebody who has an ulcer, oh my God. God is healing pancreatic cancer right now. Amen. Somebody is watching and you're praying for someone with pancreatic cancer. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, I just pray for that one, and I rebuke that cancer from that pancreas, and I speak life, not death, in Jesus' mighty name. Do you have something, Pat?
Yes, I feel like for those that are in despair,
yes,
you must just believe that you will be victorious and overcoming.
Yes, that's what the book of Revelation is all about, being victorious, because he was victorious in his death and resurrection. You too will be victorious and overcoming Satan. You will have victories if you only believe and step forward and allow God to use you. You will have victory in your life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. Dementia. The Lord is healing dementia. Mm-hmm. Some woman who's watching, you know you have dementia and your children are watching. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come against that spirit of dementia of the mind. May the Holy Spirit of God fill that mind in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. God is delivering alcoholism tonight. It's very, very strong. He's delivering alcoholics, and drug addicts. Oh, my God. There's homosexuals that you prayed to God and prayed to God to be delivered of homosexuality, and God is touching you right now. He's touching you right now. Just open your heart to the Holy Spirit. and you shall receive the power of God. As the Holy Spirit falls upon you, you shall receive power in your life to move as God has called you to move. Praise God.
Praise God.
You shall receive. You will receive power. I issue that power of God to you right now in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And you will be, you're having a Spirit of God come upon you to witness. Right now, He's touching your mind and your tongue to witness for Jesus Christ. Amen. Just raise your hands and receive that, beloved brothers and sisters. Receive that in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Patricia?
Yeah, I feel that you need to ask for the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
That it increase in your life.
Call that fire.
Call it upon you.
That heat that you're feeling is the power of the Holy Spirit. If you're feeling dizzy or you're feeling weak, it's the power of the Holy Spirit, that power of God that He's given unto His brethren that call out for it. You will receive power of the Holy Spirit of God, power to go forth. Power. God has given you power to go through the trials. He's giving you trials. He's giving you the fire to go through the trials.
Amen.
Receive that right now in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Pat?
Hallelujah. I just feel you need to ask more of the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit would increase in your life in terms of directing you, guiding you, leading you.
Yes.
Giving you answers.
Yes.
That only God can give you.
Pat,
only the Lord can answer
yes.
some of your prayers.
There's several people out there that are seeking answers. They're seeking wisdom. And God is giving it to you right now through the power of the Holy Spirit. Open up to Jesus. As Pat says, ask Him. Open up and believe God for the impossible. There's someone who's going through a litigation, a court litigation, and you believe it's absolutely impossible for you to win. The Lord says, victory is yours. Receive that victory right now for that court litigation. In the name of Jesus, He's going to work a miracle for you. You're going to go to court and you're going to win. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You will receive power after the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Just call out to the Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
If you start speaking in another language, that's the language of the Holy Spirit. There is somebody, God is healing ulcers and all kinds of stomach problems. Oh, and with your intestines, God is healing someone with intestinal problems. You're having problems with your intestines. God is touching that right now. He's touching those intestines. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's touching that right now. Hallelujah. Can we replay that music, please? Thank you. Just call on the Holy Spirit. Lord, there are people that have to find places to live. You can't afford where you're living right now. God says he's going to direct you to those places. He's going to direct you to those places, brothers and sisters. So be open to the voice of the Holy Spirit. There's a special anointing right now for the people in the sound booth. For Alan and the guys in the sound booth, God is pouring a special anointing upon your life. A special anointing for your ministry of what you're doing in the sound booth.
Yes, Father.
He's pouring a special anointing for your families. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus. He's pouring a special anointing upon you. Come, Holy Spirit, fill our lives, fill our families, fill our homes with the power of your Spirit. God is sending special angels to homes right now. The other day, I got a prophecy that there were special angels in my home. Now the prophecy is yours. There are special angels assigned to you and your family in your homes. So just know that angels are helping you. There's someone who's at a very difficult job, and God has assigned angels to you at that job. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I feel like there's some of you that are having a lot of fear. That fear is immobilizing you in your life, that you can't move forward. And the Lord wants to break that right now.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we break the spirit of fear. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. I come against the spirit of fear, and I break it now. I break those chains of fear on you, on your family, in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord says, go forth, my beloved, for I am is with you, saith the Lord. Go forth as never before, for I am pouring grace into your heart and pouring grace into your mind, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
We also speak against any oppressive spirits that are on you today.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I come against any spirits of oppression, and I curse them and break them in Jesus' mighty name. I curse the alcoholic spirit right now. I curse it. I curse it, and I break it. I speak deliverance to those who are alcoholics watching today and hearing today. I speak deliverance to those who are on drugs. Who are on drugs, especially there's someone watching that's on the needle and you beg God to help you right now. I speak deliverance to that one in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Deliverance, I speak it to you. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, that fear. That fear is so strong. God is breaking that fear. He's breaking it. Just receive it in Jesus' mighty name. You know, Pat, there needs to be forgiveness. We need to operate in the power of the Holy Spirit. We need to forgive those who have hurt us. So right now, I'm issuing the power of God to you and the grace to you to forgive those who have hurt you. In Jesus' mighty name, I set you free of unforgiveness. I set you free from unforgiveness in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah.
Yes, let not the spirit of unforgiveness hold you back.
Yes.
From where God is calling you to go,
yes. What
how he wants to use you in your life, for his kingdom, for the future advancing of his kingdom, for his glory,
Amen.
For his plan.
Amen.
In this day.
There's several of you that want to be used by God. I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, those raise their hands and want to be used of it, want to receive that power of the Holy Spirit. I issue the power of the Holy Spirit to them, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, fill them now. Fill them now with direction. Fill them now with witness, with the spirit of witnessing in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I ask that you fill everyone that's watching with grace to go through the trials that are being sent their way, Father. Whatever the trials are, sickness, family trials, financial trials. God, give them the grace and wisdom on how to get through those trials in Jesus' mighty name. Patricia?
Speaking of financial trials, I feel that God is the only one that really can help relieve you of your financial trial, because only he knows in his divine wisdom how that's to come to pass. So I stand in agreement with you on that.
Please, Jesus, that financial victory. The Lord says, victory is yours if you call out to him. Victory is yours if you call out to him. Receive that power of the Holy Spirit right now. Receive that power. Receive that power in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. There's somebody that haven't been able to walk. Move those legs. Move those legs back and forth. Start with your feet. God is loosening you. God is loosening those legs right now. Please call in and let us know. Please call in and let us know. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. That depression is leaving. Would you call out to Jesus? Jesus, 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 in Jesus' mighty name. Call out to him that your home may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you. Receive that power of the Holy Spirit as we leave you till next week, so we can continue on the book of Revelation. For everyone should know that book of Revelation, especially in this hour. May God the Holy Spirit fill your heart and fill your family and fill your home. And may special angels be assigned to you in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you.
And we issue God's grace to be an overcomer.
Amen.
Amen.
That's power.